In the 80s and early 90s, without the internet, most players turned to specialized magazines to gather information about video games. Third-generation consoles started being sold in Brazil in 1989, and shortly after that, the first dedicated video game magazines began being published. I've always enjoyed browsing through those magazines, learning about new releases and reading reviews about the games. Those magazines had a letter section where readers could send comments, suggestions, and doubts to be answered by the so-called experts. It were simpler times when there was no such thing as a question too dumb to be asked. Everything was fresh and new, and everybody was learning. For that reason, you would get lots of curious questions, such as, why can't I connect the Game Gear cartridge I bought to my Atari 2600? I got this Mega Drive cartridge. How can I use it with my Atari? Can I use SEGA's light gun and 3D glasses with my Atari 2600? Since the previous generation's best-selling console was the 2600, to the point where it was almost a synonym for video games in Brazil, it was natural that people wanted to know if their old machine could give them access to this new batch of games and accessories. But there was a particular question regarding the new generation that kept being asked over and over in many forms. Why doesn't Nintendo make an adapter for SEGA consoles? Is it true that an adapter to play Master System games on Nintendo consoles is about to be released? What is the name of the adapter that allows for Nintendo games to be played on the Master System? I know the Master System doesn't have an adapter for Nintendo cartridges, but what if someone invented a chip to do so? As the two most popular consoles at the time in Brazil were the SEGA Master System and the Nintendo Entertainment System, or more specifically, its clones, it was only natural that kids wanted to play the games available for their rival system. The same happened to their accessories, and one accessory that both systems had in common was the light gun. Nintendo released the video shooting series light gun for the Famicom in 1984, and redesigned and rebranded it as the Zapper for the NES in 1985. SEGA released the Light Phaser for the SEGA Master System in 1987. In Brazil, the Light Phaser was available since the Master System launch in 1989, but the Zapper was only released in 1994, when Nintendo finally released the NES in Brazil. But the NES clones available earlier in the market had their own Zapper clones, such as the Top Game's PVG 9000. The choice of games that used those light guns was a bit limited, but that doesn't mean they were not popular. They were so popular that in 2009, 20 years after its first release in Brazil, a man used the light phaser to hold a woman hostage for 10 hours. To prevent this kind of incident, the United States government decided to pass a law in 1988 requiring that all toy guns had an orange plug at the end of the barrel to distinguish them from real guns. Nintendo decided to play it safe and made an almost completely orange version of the Zapper in 1989. But that didn't stop a man from spray painting it black and using it to rob a gas station in the United States earlier this year. And those guns don't even look as realistic as Nintendo's video shooting series or the first home video game light gun ever, the Magnavox Shooting Gallery Rifle, released in 1972. But I digress. When it comes to using accessories from one console to another, you may think that it was obvious that the Zapper wouldn't work with the Master System, or the Light Phaser with an NES, because the connectors in those guns are very different. But if you lived in Brazil and you happened to have a Phantom System, an NES clone released by Gradiente, you would be entitled to be confused, as not only its laser gun LGH shares the same connector, but also its design is completely ripped off of the Light Phaser. Gradiente wasn't the first offender, though, as Sinclair had also ripped off its design and name, and SEGA also used it for a zillion anime-based laser tag game. Even though they are very similar, if you try to use the Phantom System's laser gun LG8 on a Master System, or if you try to use the Light Phaser on the Phantom System, the accessories won't work. And the reason is partially due to differences in how they work. The Zapper and all its clones like the light gun LG8 usually works as a simple light sensor. Whenever the trigger is pressed, the screen goes black for a split second and then white rectangles are shown where the targets are. If the gun is pointed toward one of those targets, it detects the white light and sends a signal to the console informing that the target was hit. The gun doesn't really know where it was pointed at, it just knows that it saw a black screen followed by white light. When multiple targets are shown, the game cycles the white rectangles for each target, so the game actually detects when more than where you press the trigger. The timing is so important that it is the main reason why the Zapper doesn't work with modern LCD TVs. Modern TVs have a lag to display the image on screen, so when the trigger is pulled, the white rectangle is not there yet to be seen, and the game interprets it as a miss. There are ROM hacks that compensate for this lag, making it possible to play those games on modern TVs. But only when using clone light guns, as the other reason the Zapper doesn't work on modern TVs is that it has a filter that prevents it from seeing the lights coming from the LCD TVs. That filter is not present in many clone light guns. The light phaser works in a more sophisticated way, similar to how light pens work. When the trigger is pulled, the whole screen blinks in a different color and the light phaser detects it. But how does it know if it was a hit or a miss? Differently from the Zapper, the light phaser knows where the gun is pointed at due to how CRT TVs work. CRT stands for cathode ray tube, so CRT TVs are actually tubes with an electron gun that emits a beam that illuminates a phosphorescent screen. The beam scans the screen from top to bottom and left to right, one line at a time. But this happens fast enough that we're not able to see it. When the trigger is pulled, the light phaser sensor is focused on a small circle on the screen and it can see when the beam that is drawing the blank screen enters this circle, sending a signal to the console so it can calculate the X and Y coordinates of the center of this circle. For that reason, some games can actually display bullet holes where the gun was pointed at when the player misses the target, something that doesn't happen on the NES with the Zapper. But just like the Zapper, the light phaser cannot be used in modern TVs. In this case, it is because there's no electron beam to be detected. So, can you use a light phaser to play Zapper games on the NES? With a proper adapter, yes. So you could also use it to play games on a clone console. The adapter is needed not only because the wiring is different, but also because the triggering mechanism is inverted. A pull trigger in the Zapper is a release trigger in the light phaser, and vice versa. Of course, such an adapter was never released commercially, so I built one following the schematics provided by Bujakusha, and I'm sorry if I mispronounced it. I'll provide a link for his video in the description. I adapted it replacing the NES connector side with a DE9 connector, like the one in the Phantom system. The adapter is really easy to assemble, and after a couple of minutes of soldering, I had a functional adapter. I didn't mind making a proper case for it as I just wanted to test it. At first, I thought everything was working fine, until I noticed the trigger was still inverted. The game only registered a shot after I released the trigger, not when I pulled it. I went back to the schematics and saw that when converting the adapter from the Atari XT1 to the Zapper, Bujakusha actually placed the inverter in the sensor line, not the trigger one. So I placed the inverter in the trigger line, and now the trigger was acting correctly, but the light sensor wasn't working anymore. So I figured the inverter was needed for both lines to make it behave just like a normal Zapper, and I added it to the circuit. Here are my revised schematics for the adapter to be used with the Phantom System, Top Game and Turbo Game. Now let's test it using this beautiful Brazilian exclusive game, Crime Busters, developed by BitCorp and released by Gradiente and Dismac in 1989. After a while, I realized this isn't the normal behavior of a Zapper at all. If you play Duck Hunt on an emulator, you'll see the gun shoots only when you release the mouse button, not when you press it. And this also happens in games like Wild Gunman and Hogan's Alley. The Zapper is built in such a way that the switch is released once you pull the trigger all the way. You can keep the switch on by holding it halfway, but the most obvious thing to do is to pull it all the way. That's probably why games such as Duck Hunt and Wild Gunman only register a shot when the switch is released, that is, when the trigger was pulled all the way. As the light phaser doesn't have such a mechanism, its normal behavior in those games is to only shoot when you release the trigger and the switch with it. But it feels weird, and it seems that people at Gradiente knew about it because differently from the Zapper, the light gun LGH shoots in games such as Duck Hunt when you first activate the switch by pulling the trigger. They inverted the trigger signal so it would feel more natural to the person playing it. My dual inverter adapter actually makes the gun feel like a Zapper, but work like a light gun LG8. It is a common belief that the opposite wouldn't be possible, that is, to use a Zapper to play Master System games. Many people seem to think that a Zapper wouldn't be able to give the proper readings for the calculation of the X and Y coordinates of a target. But just because most games don't make use of this information, it doesn't mean the light gun cannot actually provide it. This is Zap Rudder, a Zapper testing program. It has an X-tracking test that, according to the developer, isn't very useful, as the horizontal position detection is very noisy. But it shows that even if it is noisy, it is actually possible. However, the light phaser is more precise than my light gun LG8, and probably more precise than the original Zapper, as can be seen in this test. Notice how much less noisy the horizontal position of the light phaser is. Since the Zapper and the light gun LG8 are capable of giving X and Y coordinates, I made the adapter work the other way, this time with a breadboard to make things a little easier. However, it only worked once, and I filmed it just to show a friend, so I'm sorry for the vertical video. I'm not sure why I couldn't make it work anymore, but you can try this yourself. Since the light phaser is today cheaper than the Zapper clones, as they were more popular back in the day and thus more abundant today, this could be an interesting alternative for those who want to enjoy Zapper games on their clone consoles without their respective clone light guns. I hope you found this interesting, and if you did, please hit the like button. And if you're interested in other hardware fixes and modifications, be sure to watch this video next.